first important thing that I think a lot of people forget is that you need to start getting ready the night before. A couple ways you can do this is you can, one, braid your hair. You can just French braid your hair. I am absolutely terrible at French braiding, so please do not judge me. But anyways, it's just a really cool way to get some no heat waves. Or if your hair actually holds heat really well, you can curl or straighten your hair the night before. Then in the morning, all you'll have to do is just touch up a few things and then you're good to go. Now it is the mostly dreaded time of the day, actually waking up and getting out of bed. So this next tip will help with that. It is absolutely super underrated, and that is to have a sweatshirt right next to your bed, because your bed can be super cozy, but we need to get out of bed. So make sure to put the sweatshirt on and then you'll be all warm and cozy and then you can start getting ready. I don't know about you, but I always forget to save time for packing my backpack. And so I think I'm all ready to go. And then I'm like, oh shoot, I have to pack my backpack. So I think just packing your backpack first thing in the morning, it'll save some stress when you're trying to run out the door because you know you already have everything. And if you're feeling extra put together, you might even pack your backpack the night before. Of course, the next thing we need to do is pick out our outfit. And I know this can be super time consuming for a lot of people. I mean, it isn't really for me because I'm not really a fashion person, but besides that, I think my number one tip is to pick out something simple like jeans and a t-shirt, jeans and a sweater. Don't try to be like a fashionista when you have like 2 minutes to get out the door, okay? The next thing we would usually do is to style our hair, but if you took the tip that I gave you to do it the night before, you could basically skip this step and just quickly do some touch-ups, but if you didn't, let me help you out real quick. Honestly, I feel like everybody has those go-to hairstyles, so just stick to them. Don't try to do anything fancy, okay? We both know you don't got time for that. Then we will head over to where we do our makeup, and I know this takes like no time for some people and like an hour for other people, but I would suggest if you do wear makeup to stick to 3 products, which I know sounds crazy. If I were to wear makeup to school, I would do my brows, my eyelashes, and put on some lip gloss. But for you, that might be concealer and eyelashes or foundation. Just try to stick to 3 products. Just try not to go full glam. And in times like these, just be grateful that natural makeup is a trend. So we love that. And by the way, all the products I am using, I will link in the description box, so don't worry about that. So now we're gonna go eat breakfast. And no, this is not an option. You are eating breakfast. I don't care if it's a granola bar that you take and eat on the way to school. I don't care if it's like a full like smoothie bowl, okay? Honestly, I don't know how people skip breakfast. I'm always hungry. But you know, if you tend to do that, don't. It's not healthy. Another thing we can absolutely not skip is hygiene. You need to make sure you're brushing your teeth, putting on deodorant, all that fun stuff. Now it is time to absolutely sprint out the door. Make sure you grab your backpack, your socks and shoes, and your lunch if you pack a lunch. And of course, our phone, because we're screenagers. But yes, that is absolutely all I have for you guys. I really hope you enjoyed watching this video. And if you did, go ahead and subscribe, because that would low-key make my day, not gonna lie. So yeah, go ahead, subscribe. Okay, love you guys so much, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.